Friends off, for now.
With little fanfare, another bounty hunt comes to a close. Waters around Trash Island, where they enjoy a steady diet of hypodermic needles and used pregnancy tests. '73 was a magical time in Port Clovis when local favorite Trash Talk placed 20th in the Derby and the city placed first in the country for petty theft. Sharks in their place. Hunters ensure they'll stay in their lane, so we don't have a Planet of the Apes situation on our hands.
Everyone's life should be embarrassing, right? But in Port Clovis, they put up a monument. Gotta do the best at something.
Come on.
would be more practical simply to close the beaches. But why do that when you can just set loose a gang of amphetamine-fueled locals who kill us? Savage shrimp, Pookie Paw. Behavior only further incenses Port Clovis's citizens. The shark will now be divvied up, with parts of her body sold as conversation piece curios. Swimming at a waste disposal site heightens your risk of a shark attack, not to mention all varieties of diarrheal illnesses. Clovis's communal guard against shark attacks came after experimentation with animal sacrifices to appease the shark god, Dakiwaka. Are capable of capturing previously unseen animal behavior, unlike this commonly seen animal behavior. The shark hunting sector has experienced significant growth, leaving a lot of local opportunities for amusement ride operators. The fishing phenom, Candyman Curtis. Shark's cartilaginous skeleton can now benefit humanity as a medically unproven cure for eczema, phlebitis, and peptic ulcers. Fish higher on the food chain are more mobile, able to traverse a variety of waters. Intensive shark hunt is now underway.
Dead horse leg needs a shark examination.
The fishing phenom, Candyman Curtis. Shark will now be divvied up, with parts of her body sold as conversation piece curios. Any body of water saturated with sewage or slaughterhouse wastes can be quite appealing to sharks. Rowboats are the most common type of boat found near waterfronts, so this is a mundane sight hardly worth remarking upon. Shark hunters kill for the same reason we all do, to feel complete.
Simon on Dead Horse Lake?
The fishing phenom, Candyman Curtis.
He's one of the bounty for a real live man-eater. Let's roll!
Close. She's real close.
I'm gonna
Despite Port Clovis's best efforts, the aquatic beast refuses to be tamed. Possible that this shark's coarse textured skin will someday make a really neat anti-pickpocket wallet. While the state of Dead Horse Lake is alarming, we can be assured that a new era of environmental stewardship will restore order to our treasured wild places. Retaliates against the shark by sending some of its most disreputable citizens. Recipes are available upon request from the Gulf Coast Fisheries Association in their pamphlet, 8 Ways to Prepare Bull Shark. water's murkiness, or turbidity, can significantly raise the risk of a shark attack. Shark's hatred for boats and all other creations of man is unmistakable. Oh, God, stop! In pursuit of a dangerous shark, those closest to them prepare for the possibility that they might come home. The shark is known to be a voracious, if hardly discriminating, eater.
Ah!
bull sharks have been known to eat echinoderms when desperate, to which I can very much relate. Is now an adult, and she should probably spend less, save more, and start researching indexed mutual funds. Vigilante fever has seized Port Clovis, making it dangerous for anything that's loose. Shark's liver oil can now be processed into a high-grade lubricant. Nowhere is the irreversible degradation of the natural environment more on display than Dead Horse Lake. Thank you. places see more human fatalities caused by giant catfish than sharks, such as the Amazon Basin or Splash Mania Water Park in Garland, Texas. Have close friends or family members who have been eaten or happy by sharks.
Thank you.
disreputable citizens have converged on the area.
See it?
The Hoosier hotshot, Ensign Tyler Dixon.
All available CG personnel are encouraged to respond. Let's put down this shark, huh?
As the situation further escalates.
Yeah.
am I just seeing things?
The instinctual hunger response to the sudden presence of an available meal. Handyman special overlooking breathtaking panoramic lake views. Open living with vintage appeal. Call Depp.
Say what you want. Them hobos, good workers. Unlike my so-called son. That's why I pay him to stay on the lookout for that shark.
Actively seeks out sharks only to destroy them. As one can see, routine micro practices of risk management haven't really been effective in cleaning up this area. running out for our shark. Hunters are on the water, bringing their explosives and poor impulse control with them.
Kill another fisherman, that's between them and him, yeah?
Any panic from the shark's target could spell death. Constantly reminded of how man's intrusion has disrupted the fragile equilibrium of the world. I'd like to assure the Antolini crime family that this footage will in no way be used in the final edit of our program. Thank you. It's here in the grotto that the shark can discover the absolute serenity deep within her soul. A sea turtle carries a criminal penalty of up to $100,000, but sharks are notoriously profligate when it comes to paying fines. Dead Horse Lake serves as a salient metaphor for human fallibility in the face of avoidable catastrophe. Wary eyes and robust physique, the grouper is the very picture of brute strength. Thank you. appreciate the grant from Sunshine Solutions that made this show possible. We'd also like to remind viewers that mass cloning and gene editing for today's military is safer than ever. Tooth Nightmare, the Barracuda. This is about saving lives, but it's also about safeguarding tourism revenue. Most recognize it as the title of a classic rock radio staple. Did you know that it's also a fish? Well, it's true. It seems Port Clovis has forgotten all about its rogue shark, for now. Is a driving force for the bull shark. back on board the Cajun Queen.
That's Kyle, my son. He's just here for the summer. Studies marine biology. Look at that. I got one hand can still tie a hook. You got two, can barely tie his shoes. Must get that from his mama. Yeah. Used to help my daddy around. Spent a lot of time together. But we wasn't close. He was a shark hunter, that's all he was. If anybody were gonna catch the mega, it'd be him. Thought it was a government experiment, got himself loose. Boy, he wanted that job. Wanted it bad. Found it once. Didn't catch it, no.
What happened to your father? Huh? What happened?
Look, I ain't got time to answer questions all day. Got work to do.